The dream was, I guess, like many of these young people, to reach a certain level as a dancer and be able to make a living doing something that she passionately loved.
The curtain falls for a dancer whose life ended abruptly when she was killed by an alleged drunk driver.
Elena Shapiro is a ballerina from Winston-Salem who studied at the School of the Arts at a very early age.
Today, we spoke to some of her colleagues. Jermont Terry joins us live now from Wake Forest University with tonight's big story at 6 o'clock. Jermont.
Wanda, Elena Shapiro loved to dance, and her passion for the art stretched from the triad where she mastered her craft all the way to the triangle where she joined the Carolina Ballet. Tomorrow, family and friends will gather here at Waite Chapel to say goodbye to a dancer taken away too soon.
The poise, posture, the stage presence.
Perfect physique for ballet.
Even at the young age of 13, Elena Shapiro proved her passion for dance.
Angelic face, no tension in the body.
Dance instructor and family friend Jula Pandey teaches ballet at Wake Forest University.
She and I worked in this studio 3 weeks ago.
But today his mind wanders back to one of his favorite students.
It is just a huge tragedy for many of us. We are heartbroken.
His pain evolves around how the triad dancer's life took a tragic turn. Raleigh police say Dr. Raymond Cook, an assistant professor at UNC School of Medicine in Chapel Hill, and a doctor at Waite Med Hospital, slammed into Shapiro from behind.
Driving 85 miles per hour with his Mercedes-Benz that is obviously full of wonderful airbags and protection devices, and he walked away with some bumps and bruises. And this innocent young person taken from all of us.
The 20-year-old Shapiro died from the crash. She started dancing at an early age. This video shows her at age 13 in a concert at Wake Forest. In 2007, she graduated from the University of North Carolina School of Arts. She then joined the Carolina Ballet.
Her dream was, I guess, like many of these young people, to reach a certain level as a dancer and be able to make a living doing something that she passionately loved.
But friends say Cook took that dream away. The doctor appeared in the Raleigh courtroom to answer to the charges of death by motor vehicle, driving while intoxicated, failure to reduce speed, and reckless driving.
It's a shock.
Now friends hope the ballerina's death will not be in vain.
You just go on the hope that something good can come out of it.
Dr. Cook pled not guilty in court today and then was released on a $51,000 bond. Meanwhile, family and friends will pay their respects to Shapiro tomorrow here out at Waite Chapel at a noon service. Reporting live tonight, Jermont Terry, WXII 12 News.
Thanks, Jermont. Well, drunk driving continues to be a problem in our state. In 2008, there were nearly 12,000 alcohol-related crashes, resulting in 433 fatalities. You want to stay with WXII 12 News as we continue to cover the death of Elena Shapiro. You can also learn more about her and the man accused of killing her in the crash. You'll find that on WXII12.com.